Another school shooting rocks the U.S., this time in Tennessee. The tragedy left 7 people, including 3 children, dead. Our North America Bureau Chief T.J. Manotok now joins us with the latest from there. T.J., good afternoon from Manila.
Good evening, Hermina. And you know what? As you said, America woke up to yet another tragic school shooting today as a lone female shooter took the lives of 3 children and 3 adults at a Christian school in Nashville, Tennessee. At around 10:13 a.m., police were alerted of an active shooter inside Covenant School. They deployed officers on the scene, and within 14 minutes, the shooter was taken down. Officials have identified the victims as 9-year-olds Evelyn Dakehouse, Haley Scruggs, and William Kinney, along with 3 adults who worked at the school: Cynthia Peak, age 61, Mike Hill, age 61, and Catherine Koontz, age 60, who was said to be the head of the school. The shooter, identified as 28-year-old Audrey Hale, a former student at that school, was armed with at least 2 assault rifles and a handgun. Police later found a manifesto and detailed maps of the school on the suspect. According to Nashville Police Chief John Drake, the shooting appears to have been a targeted attack. The shooter entered Covenant School through a side door and moved through the building, firing multiple shots. Officers responding to the scene engaged the shooter on the second floor, where she was fatally shot. Covenant is a private Christian school in Nashville for preschool through 6th grade. Last year, the school actually held an active shooter training program. The community is in shock, and the governor has called for prayers for the victims and their families. President Biden has also addressed the shooting, calling it sick and heartbreaking.
We're monitoring the situation really closely, Ben, as you know, and we have to do more to stop gun violence. It's ripping our communities apart, ripping the soul of this nation, ripping at the very soul of the nation. You know, the shooter in this situation reportedly had 2 assault weapons and a pistol, 2 AK-47. So I call on Congress again to pass my assault weapons ban. It's about time that we began to make some more progress, but there's more to learn. But I just wanted to send my concern and hearts out to so many parents out there.
Casey, this is the 129th mass shooting in the U.S. this year alone. That's according to the Gun Violence Archive. Casey?
Right, very difficult to watch the footage that we were showing our viewers. Again, just a note to our viewers, viewer discretion, please. I mean, if you're this can easily trigger parents, most especially, seeing all these images there. But DJ, talk to us about the gun laws there in Tennessee, and how was it possible that this person, you know, was able to get its hands on 2 assault rifles? Mm-hmm. DJ.
Well, the moment the news broke out, Casey, there was so much talk on the news networks and on online, and it was easily pointed out Tennessee has some of the weakest gun laws in the country. There is no waiting period between purchasing and receiving a firearm. There's no license or permit required to own a gun. No need to register a gun with the state. You don't need a permit to carry a handgun, open or concealed, if you're over the age of 21. So if you're over the age of 21, it's like buying candy from a store. It seems to me with basically no permits required, no need to register it. It's probably even harder to buy a vehicle. And sadly, the criticism on the local legislature of Tennessee and the governor, they've even been trying to make it easier to purchase guns in the last year. So all the spotlight is on them right now. Once again, the federal government, the White House, President Biden, appealing to Congress and hoping that they will finally take action on their assault weapons ban. That's one of the things they want to happen, at the very least, take away these assault weapons, the AK-47s. It should not be that easy to purchase and walk around and shoot multiple people in a matter of seconds. And that is the first step that they're trying to do, amongst many other things about background checks, red flag laws. Not unless all these states get together or at least have a federal law. You know, time and again, you know, these people wake up to tragedies like this, sadly, and America, again, as I said, seeing the 129th mass shooting just this year alone. We haven't even ended the month of March.
All right, we're going to have to leave it at that. And of course, we hope that that number won't go up any further. Our North America Bureau Chief there, TJ Banotok, joining us this afternoon. Thanks again, Teej. The Energy Department urges the National Grid Corporation of the Philippines to appeal the denial of its request for an extension on its standby power supply deals. That's after the NGCP warned the decision could lead to power outages. The NGCP earlier called on the DOE to intervene after the Energy Regulatory Commission rejected its petition to continue with the month-on-month extensions on its ancillary service agreements. But the DOE now says the grid operator should file a motion for reconsideration before the ERC. It adds it is the job of the NGCP to ensure stable power supply, and it should live up to that responsibility.